Hey, don't be a pussy. Subscribe to Theo Frickin' Door, man. All the cool people are doing it. We're doing it. I don't give a fuck.
What the fuck? Holy shit, that scared the hell out of me, kids. Man, is this is gonna be a doozy. You can see I'm back on the hog. Philip, let's go. Good, I guess. Hell no, kid. Yeah, you like that, how I started my bike? She's purring.
So yeah, my bike's up and running. There is more than one issue this time. I want to give a huge fucking thanks and a shout out to Mike and Adam back here behind me, because if it wasn't for those guys have been working around the clock for the past couple days with me on this thing trying to figure it out. So if it wasn't for them, I probably wouldn't be running by now. The first problem that we had is my starter kept kicking out. Most of you guys saw that. The starter was shorting. There's something that's got to be loose in it, because it would only short if it was turned a certain way, which is why when I would turn a corner, the starter would kick on, and when I would turn another corner, it would kick off. I went and got a new starter, and with that new starter, I bought myself a button. You're not gonna be able to see it. Kind of a hidden button, but I have a button on the bike now that is my ignition button. So my little ignition button up here on the handlebars doesn't do anything. It'll keep the starter from engaging on a hot wire. So that took care of the starter issue. Something was shorting in the starter. I checked all the ignition buttons and switches and stuff, and they all seemed fine, so I was like real confused. But then when I pulled my starter out and bench tested the first time, it seemed fine. But I think it's because I had it turned. What up, brother? I think I had it turned at just the right point where whatever was shorting it wasn't shorting it, if that makes sense. After the starter is fixed, it still wouldn't start, right? It still would just keep cranking and cranking and cranking, but it wouldn't fire over. We checked fucking everything. We were checking spark plugs, fuel injectors. I mean, we had this thing pulled apart. When we checked the injectors, they were just kind of barely spitting out. They weren't misting like they should. We figured, okay, it's got to be a fuel pressure issue. I opened up the dash and opened the tank, and I hit the kill switch to prime the fuel lines. And when I did that, this happened.
Yeah. So, I think I might have found the issue. I don't know if this is... I don't know if that's supposed to do that when I prime it. Shit.
That was a lot of gas spitting where it's not supposed to spit. Where my fuel filter is, the canister that holds my fuel filter has an O-ring on it. Well, that O-ring was just like flattened out, so gas was just spitting past it when it was trying to prime it. Went and bought an O-ring, replaced the O-ring, and it fixed that issue. But then we saw that the fuel line coming from the pump to the fuel filter had a little pinhole in it as well, and it was spraying. So I woke up, went to Harley. They told me how much the line was, so I walked out of Harley. I went somewhere else and found a fuel pump assembly with a fuel line, threw that bitch in, buttoned everything back up, charged the battery up because the battery was dead from how many times we were just like cranking it over and shit. Hit the starter and she fires right up now, boys. She's firing up now, boys. We got it back up and running just in time, because right now is Cycle Gear's bike night, and I go to all the bike nights and everything, but this bike night is special. Because this bike night, Ronnie Mack, aka Uncle Ronnie, at the Cycle Gear bike night tonight. Bike's up and running just in time to go to Cycle Gear bike night and go meet fucking Ronnie Mack. So weird. Nobody like that ever comes to Tulsa. Oh, but it feels so good to have my bike running again. Dude, thank you guys for all your suggestions in the comments, because I was checking everything. When I read a comment, somebody was like, hey, check this. I had either already checked it or was about to check it. We were going through everything on this bike. This guy's shirt has a thing, like a print of a skeleton on it.
Hell yeah, brother.
Holy shit, yep, that's a lot of people.
Watch videos.
Nice. Up, dude.
Long time no see.
Hell yeah, I like the shirt.
Yeah.
That's my hoodie. Ronnie Mac. What's up, dude? How you doing?
What's up, man? How you going?
There we go.
Hell yeah, man.
Right
on. I still went icon. Yep.
Thanks, bro.
What's up, dude?
Ronnie Mac signed my gloves. He signed my gloves.
You guys are all, aww, like I'm a fucking child. Oh yeah, he's crushing some PBR. There
you go. Hey, cool, back later.
What's going on, buddy?
What's up, dude?
How you doing?
My bike wheelies again. The Baker X Derek overload so people can say, oh, he never watches Baker.
Oh man, well that was a crazy day. Got to meet Uncle Ronnie. Got my bike working again. I still need to work on them clutch plates. I didn't do anything about the clutch plates. Woo! Hell no. That was a big old doink of a bump. Yeah, Kevin's got the right idea.
Hey, dude, that scared the fuck out of me. It just like bounced.
I see you. My bike's running again! Well, that's probably gonna conclude this video for you guys. Crazy fucking day. Day that I get my bike fixed, Ronnie Mac shows up. It's like he knew. He showed up in Tulsa and filled Tulsa with all them screaming eagles. And that gave me the energy I needed to get this thing back up on the road. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you everybody so much for watching. And I will see you guys on the next one.